Hi, I'm Samantha and I'm 20. I've been everywhere the last past year because I lie. Yes, you lie too, but I have an addiction. I lie about my gender, my age, my life. It all started with this one time my mom was going to a restaurant with me. She told me to say I was 6 so she didn't have to pay for me. I was 10 but I was short so they believed it. After that, I kept lying. I told my teacher I couldn't go to school because I broke my leg. Then a month later my teacher came to visit me and saw that my leg isn't broken. I told her the doctor said that my leg would heal within 3 weeks. So all she said was tomorrow, I want you back in school. I went back the next day and the cops and social workers were waiting for me at the front door of my classroom. They asked me if I was Samantha Rodriguez. I said no. They believed it, but then saw my school ID. They took me to a foster home. They asked me if they should know something, and I said I was trans. They accepted me that way, but when I visited my mom, she asked her why she let me get surgery. She said I was naturally a girl. They threw me out. I lived in the streets till I was 18, and I found a job. They asked me if I wanted to join them in the school. They also asked me if I had any experience in teaching. I said yes so I could work and get money. They let me. Later, when I was 19, they found out the truth. They kicked me out. I went to buy a car with the money I made. I found another job being a maid. I got the job. I was taking care of their laundry when I saw a letter saying their combination for the box. I put the combination in and saw stacks of gold and money. This meant they were rich. I kept telling myself they won't notice a thing. I took some money they didn't notice. I waited for a month and they had no idea. So I did it again. I created a new addiction. This one was different from lying, but it included lying. I stole. Every month I started stealing their money and stuff. I sold it and got my own house. I had to leave when they died. I killed them after I heard them trying to call the cops on me. I hid their bodies underground. I thought no one would see me. But a few weeks later the neighbors called the cops on me saying I worked for them, and I killed them. I was wondering how they found out. Him realized that they told me to never go in a room down in the basement I didn't even care about because I was scared of basements. I don't know if that's a phobia, but if it is, I got that one. I think there were that room was the TV that was connected to the cameras. I knew there were cameras, but I didn't know that the outside had cameras as well. How dumb was it if they had cameras inside, they had to have some outside. Sometimes I don't use my head. They asked me if I knew them, and I said no. They also asked me different questions, but I didn't answer. I said I would say anything else till my lawyer came. They left me alone for a while and gave me coffee. My lawyer finally came and kept saying if there's no evidence that I killed them, I shouldn't be going to jail. They said there was evidence and they showed me and my lawyer the video. They took us to court the next month. They said they would let me free if there was no evidence I killed them. There was no evidence because the other lawyer wasn't there yet. When he was about to close the case, the other lawyer came saying I have evidence she's guilty. The judge saw the evidence, and I went to jail. They took me to jail for stealing and lying and for murder. I turned 20 in jail. I saw one of the workers going to take a shower. I said I needed to use the bathroom. I took her clothes. I said if I could go home cause there was an emergency. They let me go. I finally got out. I went back to my house and sold all of my stuff with the house. I bought flight tickets and got a new look of hair. I want to live a new life in another country. Found out my mom died. Wanted to kill myself, but I went to college for her. I went to college and met some friends. Everyone asked me where I was from. I said from New York that I was living with a famous celebrity, but they went on a vacation here and wanted me to try this school out just in case we move here. Got my degree and graduated college early and got a new job. I started to go to a therapist and she told me I had an addiction to lying. They send me to jail for psycho crazy sick people and I could only get out when they say I'm not a danger to the world. So I lied about everything. I acted like I was okay and they believed it. I got out 3 years later. I'm 24 now. I continue with my addiction. That was the story I told my future boss, so I could get a job at the book company. I got the job. CK, I lied to you too. I ended up in jail again for false information for the psycho crazy sick people jail. They said I wasn't allowed to come out at all. But you know what's next? I think there's nothing wrong with me. See you next time.